First, explosive allegations have been aired in Parliament with MP Richard Dalla-Riva accused of illegally accessing the police database to spy on his neighbours. Mr Dalla-Riva says the claims are slanderous and unfounded. State political reporter Gareth Borum joins us live now from Parliament House. And Gareth, the manufacturing minister was brought close to tears.
Yes, in a personal explanation to Parliament this afternoon, Richard Dalla-Riva has denied any wrongdoing and spoken emotionally about his time in the Victorian Police Force when, as a detective seconded to the National Crime Authority, letter bombs were detonated outside his home. Now, all of this hasn't moved Labor, which has responded by referring to the Office of Police Integrity allegations that Mr Dalla-Riva used the police database to access information on his neighbours. And it's capped off a torrid day in Parliament, which started off with a censure motion against a former Labor minister and ended with a current frontbencher staunchly defending his innocence.
A government assault on Labor.
The member for Essendon is unfit to hold the office of the front bench down there.
Quickly turned into a surprise counter-attack on the manufacturing minister. Claims that as a policeman, he misused the force's LEAP database to snoop on prospective neighbours.
In the minister's own version, own bizarre version of location, 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 before he bought his house, he leaped the entire street.
Order! Order!
An emotional Richard Dalla-Riva denying any wrongdoing.
The LEAP database was never illegally accessed by me. The claims today by the ALP are completely false, and I'll be formally writing to the Leader of the Opposition today demanding that he publicly apologise.
The Premier challenged in question time to investigate the claims against his minister.
If the Leader of the Opposition has some allegations to make, then I suggest he makes them.
The allegations against the manufacturing minister have overshadowed the government's censure motion against the former planning minister, the coalition calling on the opposition leader to sack Justin Madden from Labor's front bench over the Hotel Windsor affair.
He embarked on a sham consultation process and then, in my view, hid behind the skirts of a young woman and allowed her to, quote 10, take the hit.
But the waffle coming from the government side is as coherent as Charlie Sheen.
The government using its numbers in the lower house chamber to censure Justin Madden with the motion passed by one vote. Gareth Borum, 10 News.